This massive beast is the Super Takumar 300mm f4. It's huge, it's heavy, it's a pain in the ass to use, and I love everything about it. So naturally, I'm going to review the snot out of it. It has been a while though. Wanna come?
I don't think this is a good idea. Maybe I should just go.
Alright, let's go. Okay. Right. Over this mound, some birds we want to shoot. Right?
Video from here.
I'm under the minimum focusing distance. Dang it.
The Super Takumar 300mm f4 is a vintage SLR prime lens produced between 1965 to 1971. At the very least, this lens is about 50 years old. Look at it. It's a thing of beauty even after all these years. It's not surprising, of course, because Takumars are built like tanks. That build quality does come at a cost though. This is a heavy lens, and on its own it weighs in at 946 grams. On the Sony A7S II, it's heavy. On the Lumix S1H, it's heavier. It doesn't really matter what you're shooting this on, sporting this thing immediately puts you into a heavyweight class, whether you're ready for it or not. Now it uses an M42 screw mount, which makes it very easy to adapt to pretty much any mirrorless or DSLR camera. And the aperture range goes between f4 and f22, and it uses a 6-blade aperture design. Now manual focus on this lens is smooth. It's a bit on the heavy side, so it takes a little getting used to. Now on the end of the lens is a built-in lens hood that can extend and collapse depending on how you want to use it. The 300mm has a 77mm filter size, which is a fairly common one and makes it easy to mount my current filter options. Now, what else can I say about the lens itself? Oh yeah, the minimum focusing distance is out there at 5.5 meters. I mean, it is the telephoto lens, so I guess that's not a big surprise, but it does require some space in your surroundings to use it effectively, which is precisely why I spent the last 2 weekends up north. Space. Lots and lots of space. And I captured it all in standard def with this Sony Hi8 camera. Now, shooting with prime lenses has really helped me see how every lens maps a unique visual path to images hidden all around. What you see when you look through your camera depends on two variables, your point of view and the focal length of your lens. And every focal length presents a different way of looking at your subject. Now, shooting with a telephoto lens zeroes in on a part of a scene, making it appear larger and closer while compressing that scene's depth of field. Now, a wide-angle lens, by comparison, reveals more of a scene and renders the subject smaller than a telephoto or standard lens. Now, changing your perspective goes a long way. I got more interesting results with this lens by avoiding shooting everything at eye level. Now, squatting down, climbing a tree, or going prone, yes, even if it makes you dirty, you can even roll over and shoot the subject against the sky. Now, I think photography demands you know what your lenses are capable of. And I feel one of the best ways to help with that is to lock a prime on your camera and force yourself to shoot with it. Now, I know this is a little philosophical, but I was thinking a lot about it when I was out shooting with this lens. Now, a dedicated telephoto isn't something I've spent a lot of time with, so I was paying close attention to my feelings while shooting with it. Now, so far, what I'm seeing out of this camera and lens combo is pretty great. Now, since I'm outside with loads of light, I never really found myself needing anything faster than f4. I did most of my shooting between f5.6 and f11, which seems to be the sweet spot of this lens anyway. Now, at f4, the typical corner-to-corner sharpness isn't quite there. It's fine in the middle, but the edges are a little dull. Now, vignetting is also evident, but stopped down to 5.6, it's pretty much gone. But various forms of chromatic aberrations are also fairly pronounced in high contrast situations, especially when wide open at f4. With modern photo editing, a simple click of a button will remove these almost entirely. So really, who the fudge cares? Chocolate fudge. Now overall, it's a fairly sharp lens. It's clearly not modern sharp, but it's organic sharp. Now because human eyes can't see as clearly as some digital devices can produce, the term organic helps me articulate the difference between a clinically sharp lens and an organically sharp lens. Does that make sense? Now the bokeh is creamy and not distracting at all, in my opinion, even with 6 aperture blades in the diaphragm. Now the fall colors here are only really enhancing the wonderful colors this lens already produces. They're accurate, well saturated, and really quite typical of my other Takumar lenses. Color, sharpness, and ergonomics are the trinity of what helped me fall in love with these lenses, and the 300mm is no exception here. Now the toughest thing about shooting with this lens is just getting over the sheer size and weight of it. And it's a lot easier to use on a tripod, but of course, then it's not as easy to shift your perspective. Now online, this lens costs anywhere between $100 and $250, and I think that's a lot of value. It already feels like there's more than that worth of metal and glass in this thing alone, never mind what it can do to help expand your photography. Now, this one is in fact a loaner all the way from Perth, Australia. 34 Media was generous enough to loan it out to me for testing, and now I want my own. Now it's probably not your everyday lens, but it's definitely one I'd love to have in my kit. I would kiss it, but it's not mine. I'll kiss my own when I get it, but not mine.
We're gonna go there tonight.
No one will see us. We're gonna do some shenanigans.
Special thanks to my daughter who shot all the high 8 footage for me. 8 years old and already 100 times better than I was at her age. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next time. Balance on the camera, it makes for a fantastic dumbbell. After shooting with this thing, I kind of feel like Dylan. You know, Dylan! You son of a bitch.
Had enough?
Make it easy on yourself, Dutch.
I'm missing my logo light. It's over there. My office has been a disaster for the last 2 weeks. Bye.